Yeah, Lupe came by the crib and ate dinner. I mean, what, you know, what can I say? Real gonna recognize real wherever you go. No matter what city, no matter what state. When people, when real people connect and cross paths, it's just an understanding. So he was cool, he wasn't even tripping. So I went and picked him and his team up. You know, they hopped in the whip, rolled back to the crib. I had to let him know, Lupe, when you get in on that passenger side, you gotta lock the door with your hand. Cause the automatic locks ain't working right now, homie. So, you know, he ain't know the rules at first. So he was leaving my car door open. I'm like, hold up, dog. This mother broke, you know what I mean? Locked that. So it was cool though, man. He was clowning me, talking about all that, the way I stay and all that type of stuff. But it was all good, man. So he came by the crib and ate. Shout out to Mia X, the biggest mama Mia. She whipped up some amazing grub for us. So we all ate good. Everybody enjoyed the food, man. Commitment and trust, but I demand that. I don't call you by your name because I consider you lame. I'm in the yo, you playing video games. I learned that Lupe loves Popeyes, and he feels like Popeyes in Louisiana definitely tastes better than Popeyes everywhere else. So we went and got some sweet tea, and this man ordered 12 biscuits and ate about 9 of them. I learned to watch out for record labels who are only hungry for hit singles. He definitely was stressing that you want to build your fan base. Your fan base is the people who are gonna love you regardless of if you got a hit song on the radio or not. Focus on building and nurturing their fan base. I learned that Lupe is really not an industry dude. Like on some real stuff, this dude ain't really know me, like talking about it, you know? He knew of me, he knew that I was an artist. This man came to the crib, hopped in the whip, you know what I mean? Like, look, let's go. It's cool, like, it's cool. And I was like, it's cool. So, like, he's not an industry, you know, another industry dude, or it didn't feel like industry interactions to me. I told that boy I was heading out on a 50 city tour in the fall, and, you know, when he saw how many dates I had coming up, I definitely learned from him about just pacing yourself on that road. And taking your time, you know, making sure that you're taking care of your body, your voice, all that type of stuff. Because he done been there and done that. A man said he used to do around 200, 300 shows a year when he was first coming up. So he was like, good luck. He started laughing when I told him I had 50. He was like, good luck. He was like, I remember them days. So definitely. I learned that when you're a person who is always inspiring people with your music and just with your energy and your performances, that it's important for you to stay inspired as well. I learned about diversifying. When it start popping off for you, you know, and you start really doing your thing, just diversifying, not being one-dimensional, like with your bread, with your means of income, you know, like open up some stores, get yourself clothing line, doing all that stuff, man. It's the stuff that Lupe does, as well as having like a Lupe Fiasco Foundation and all that stuff. All stuff that's important to me. So I was just in a situation where I was soaking up so much, you know. You probably think I'm kind of quiet, but, you know, I just was in observatory mode. Lupe really, I could tell instantly, like, he had this respect level and this spot in his heart for New Orleans. And by me being born and raised here, that automatically makes me look at him like, dog, like, I really rock with you just because you care about my city so much. Because it's so similar to Chicago as far as the heavy murder epidemic that we're going through. Just, you know, the mental slavery, man, that a lot of the youngsters and the older people, for that matter, are really playing with. Love. They waiting on me to slip, but I will not slip. Boy, these Nikes got grip. Truthfully, I don't know what's next. I know that's my homie now, so I know that we definitely family, we connected. I know he likes my music. I know I like his music. So all the fans want to know, like, are y'all gonna do, you know, some songs together? Like, that'd be crazy. You know, why not? Why wouldn't we? So, like, I'm looking forward to it. Like, I know that type of stuff is on the horizon, but music, that's what everybody wants, and I think that that's gonna happen, no doubt. But I think that beyond music, you know, on some real movement type stuff, like, that's what I'm excited about. So, we're gonna see what it is.
corn, sit back and watch me do it.
Say them boys ain't stopping, then them boys